Hey guys, what's up? Welcome to your reading. This is going to be a reading for the sign of Libra, Sun, Moon, Rising, and Venus. It is a general reading. This may or may not resonate. If it doesn't, check out your other placements. Some of the energies of the cards here can be flipped, so feel free to switch those energies, vice versa, right? Let's see. Feel free to switch the sides though, alright? Pick the side you resonate most with. And if you need a personal reading, all that information is going to be down in the description box below. You're moving on, Libra. Clearly, you're moving on. You have this distance that you have maintained, right? You're creating this physical and mental distance between the person you're dealing with and yourself. This person has been sabotaging the connection, right? And you're fed up. You're done with the mind games. You just feel defeated. And you just feel you can't deal with this anymore. And like you have no choice but to move on, but to relocate or just move on is what I'd say. Before you completely reach a point where you feel backstabbed and betrayed is what I'm getting. The person you're dealing with, right? This person's addicted to you. They're obsessed, okay? This person is very... Say they have a lot of negativity surrounding them. This person does feel very chained, tied, bound to you, but that's not what the problem is. The problem is that this person out here is obsessed with you, right? So they tend to that is another sabotaging energy, but they tend to operate out of fear. So if this person has a lot of love for you, they feel a very strong connection for you, okay? I feel this person also loves you, but the connection that they have with you, right, it's been approach, the connection is approached in a very negative way, okay, where this person feels like they love you but they can't commit to you, or they're just very sexually attracted to you, or this person is trying to run away from something committed is what I'm getting here, okay? That's what they're doing. I think this person out here knows that they love you very, very much, but they're trying to distract themselves as much as they can in order to stay away from that commitment part, in order to stay away from something stable, something committed. That's what I'm getting here. They're distracting themselves, okay? And they have a lot of sabotaging behavior, which is why you walked away. They're doing things on purpose. I mean, not on purpose. I'd say that this is the devil that's creating illusions. They feel that this is the only way to approach this situation, okay? So it's like it's not their fault, but in a way, it is their fault because they feel helpless. They feel powerless, okay? The negative patterns, thought patterns, or whatever they've been doing, if there's a third-party situation, they're in it because they feel powerless. They feel they can't do anything about this, but it's only them, in literal sense, who can do something about it. But you're just choosing to leave them where they are. I don't think you're wanting to mess with them, or you just don't want them to mess with you. All right. How do you view this connection, Libra? How does this person view this connection? How does this person view this connection? You view this person as someone, you know, they see you as very hardworking, okay? They see you as very focused on your career, your money, your goals, probably even emotionally detached, okay? And you're just focusing on yourself is how they see you. You see them as someone probably who knows they're not happy without you. You see them as emotionally codependent on you, okay? But there's this sense of arrogance coming from this person's side. They have very low self-esteem, you know, and this person knows you make them very happy. But it's that sense of arrogance, you know, that haughty nature, that proudiness, okay, where it's like they're too proud to admit that they can't do without you and you're the one that they want. That's what's happening. And you know that. You know that. And they see you as completely disinterested in them and just focused on yourself. Working hard to achieve your goals or just working hard towards yourself. Alright, tell me the mutual energy. What is the mutual energy? What is the mutual energy? What is the mutual energy? Wow, you're both being super rigid out here. None of you want to budge. The problem here is that, you know what? You both want to be in the driver's seat. That's what's happening here. You don't want to... You know, it's like you're both not within the structure right now. You both want to... are being control freaks right now, because that is a mutual energy. No one wants to budge, no one wants to give up, okay? But now probably it is this person coming off as that more than you, because I feel like you're moving on feels like you're getting to a better place. Just, you know, like picking up the pieces and just moving forward out here. Once this person can't let you go, I don't think they're letting you go. This person won't let you go. But the problem here is that both of you are being very rigid, very rigid. You both have your own insecurities. I think both of you all have that insecurity that they don't want to be dominated by the other person out here. So it's like a, you know, like an ego fight going on. Why is all this happening? Why is all this happening? Why is all this happening? Seven of Pentacles, because there's no movement out here. You're both waiting and watching. See, that's what's happening here, right? No one's taking that decisive action, thinking practically. You're both letting your emotions overpower your logic. Whereas right now you need structure, but both of you are outside your structures. You're both in that free flow energy. Everyone's doing what they want to, okay? The reason for the reading is that there's no movement out here. That's what I'm getting here, okay? You're both waiting and watching, contemplating, a lot of introspection going on. What do we need to do next, okay? I think you're both waiting and watching. Probably this person out here is not taking action towards you yet. Or I think you're not investing into them. Because you've put in all your hard work. I think this is you. You've put in all your hard work, okay? Now you're like, you know what? Now it's time for me to wait and watch, okay? Is it a good time for me to invest more? Do I want to invest more? Am I only going to be the one putting in all the work? Is there going to be any kind of reciprocity from this person? Will this person continue the negative patterns or negative behaviors? Will there be a continuation of the third party situation? Third party situation does not have to be another romantic connection. It can be a person, place, thing, thought pattern, anything, all right, that comes between you and this person that you're dealing with, all right? But right now things are at a halt, a complete pause, okay? A lot of, you know, it's like a waiting game. That's what's happening right now. So no momentum right now in your relationship. I think you were the one who's always put in the work all this while. And this person was just sitting back watching the show. Now that you have, you know, so the ball was rolling, okay? So things were going on. There was this momentum in your relationship. Now, all of a sudden, you've pulled back from this connection. Now you're putting yourself on a halt. Things are stagnant. And you're walking the other way. Hence, there is no movement in the relationship. So it's like you almost realize that when one person stops messaging, you get to know who was the one who was always making the attempt. Something like that. Okay. All right. What action do you plan on taking towards this person moving forward? Okay. What action does this person plan on taking towards you moving forward? All right. Ten of Pentacles. It looks like this person wants to heal. This person wants to heal the relationship. That's what I'm getting here. They're trying to heal, but I think there's a lot of negative self-talk from this person because I feel this person is highly influenced by a lot of negative energy. Could be in their surroundings, could be in their external environment, could be the way they think, okay? But a lot of negative self-talk from this person, okay? Every time they want to think about moving towards you, right? They keep talking themselves down. And it's a habit. It's a pattern, right? It's something that you can't break. That they can break, but they choose not to, okay? It takes a lot of inner strength to break the devil's energy and this negative self-talk. You, on the other hand, here, you're taking no action because I think you're focused on your growth, your money. You're being too materialistic. Don't take me in the wrong way. Materialistic does not mean, I don't mean like that. I just mean that you're too focused on your money. Not really focused on the stability and security of this connection, but it's like, you know what? Oh, well, if this wouldn't work out, never mind. I'm just going to move towards my career, my profession or something. You know, like how materialistic things sometimes give us pleasure, temporary, but they do, right? I think that's what you're doing. So you're not making a move towards this person. You're just rather focused on something that makes you happy, even if it is temporary, rather than focus on this connection. What's the outcome? What's the best possible outcome? Wow, the moon in reverse. So I feel that there are going to be some secrets that are going to be revealed out here, okay? I feel this person out here is finally going to release their fear, stress, and anxiety around this connection. This person out here is a very negative thinker. Let me put it out there, okay? Short and sweet. This person, whenever they think about you or otherwise also, I feel this person is someone who thinks very negatively, okay, about any situation. Probably they always think about the worst outcome that can happen, all right? And that's what's happening. And finally, in the outcome, I think this person is getting their shit together. They're releasing that fear around the situation, releasing the negative thoughts. And I think they have clarity of some sort. I feel this person wants to come towards you and talk to you. But we'll find out. What's the devil? What's the devil? Yeah, see, there is no growth and expansion out here, right? See, what's happening here? We have the emperor and the empress out here. Like I said before, you both want to be in the driver's seat. Guys, out here, right? Someone out here, I think Libra, this is you. You need to be in your feminine energy. All right? You need to be in your feminine energy. You're in your masculine energy. It does not matter if you're a man or a woman. All right? Someone out here needs to nurture that feminine side. You're being too controlling right now. This person's also has control issues. Okay? So you're both trying to control each other. Okay, and that is why this connection is not growing. There is no growth and expansion out here. I would have rather had you just sit back, relax, you know, and nurture yourself, and automatically you would be practicing the law of attraction because you're letting go, right? You don't care. You're not trying to take control of the outcome out here. But that's what's happening here. What's the Five of Swords in reverse? Yeah, because this person doesn't commit, right? So you're choosing to walk away. You're fed up of this person's non-committal ways. This person out here is a freewheeling explorer, all right, Libra? You are someone who values family, who values stability, who values peace, harmony. You're all about that, all right? And this person is the complete opposite. I think you've been quite fed up of trying to be with this person. I think initially you would have tried to be with this person in their terms, the way they wanted to, you know, say in a relationship where no one knows, or probably a relationship with no tag, or just went on, okay? Now I feel that you are like, you know what, I gave this all, my all, and you still don't seem to change, okay? And now you're just withdrawing from the connection. You're withdrawing from the connection because, like I said, this person is non-committal, all right? This person likes to do things in a non-traditional way. Six of Swords. Why is this here? I know that you've given in your best. But this person doesn't... They can't let go of their ways, is what I'm getting. Yeah. This person has a lot of love for you, alright? But they don't express themselves emotionally, okay? Look, Two of Cups here. The love is there, guys. The love is there. It's just that they don't want commitment. They want to... Now, it could be anything, okay? Keeping their options open, or they just don't like to be tied down. You can't control this person. You can't tie this person down. Take it from me, Libra. You can't do that. This person has a lot of love for you, but they don't want to be vulnerable, okay? Which is why you're choosing to walk away from them. Either this is a person who's just like that, that's their root nature, or they've had a past relationship which didn't work out. It's hurt them bad. They haven't been able to forgive and they haven't been able to heal from this past connection, which is why they're just being really stubborn and rigid about their ways. What's the Emperor? What's the Eight of Pentacles? Four of Wands. Yeah, see, this person probably is someone who now sees the connection as they want. They're viewing this connection as someone who needs to, they need to put in the work, okay? But with the Four of Wands here, they do see you as marriage material. They see you as someone they want a long-term future with, okay? They do. They see you as marriage material. And I think in order, I think by working on themselves, they're indirectly working on this connection. What's the Nine of Cups in reverse? Yeah, see, they're not happy after the breakup. They're not happy about this separation right now. And you know that. The best part is you know that. You know that they're not happy out here, okay? But I don't think this person has let go of this connection. They still haven't closed this cycle. Hence, there is no new cycle starting. They're still going on and on repeating the same cycle out here. See, it's all about their thoughts, the way they think. You know, very stubborn and rigid person. You can't shake them off. My way or the highway. What's the Emperor here? What's the Emperor in reverse? What's the Emperor in reverse? Wow. You both don't want drama, I think. I think you're both trying to avoid drama. You're both trying to avoid competition. But it's like, you know, you're both in your corners, okay? You're in your corner, they're in their corner. No one wants to fight for this connection is what I'm getting, okay? So because there's so much rigidity from both your sides, right? You're both like, it's very tough to break the ice, you know? You're both fighting for what you think is right, all right? And you both have your own insecurities that if I give up or if I give into this connection, they win. Or if they give in, you know, then you win. Not literally win-win as such, but it's just that ego, you know, of not letting go. What's the Seven of Pentacles? What's the Seven of Pentacles? I think there's more inner conflict You are in your head, they in their head. Rather than external conflict, there's inner conflict here. You both are conflicted in your own heads about what to do next. You know? Why is the Seven of Pentacles here? That's why there's waiting energy out here. Because you both don't know what to do next. What's the Seven of Pentacles here? Yeah. There is a lack of expression out here. Again, like I said, the love is there. You're holding back. They're holding back. Alright? I think this person out here is someone who loves you a lot. And they realize that. But they don't want to be vulnerable. And now you have been, you know, very lovable all this while. You've been expressing yourself emotionally. Now you're walking away because you're shut down emotionally. That's what's happening here. Now you're both in those reverse positions where no one wants to open up. No one wants to be vulnerable. Both are scared. Both are afraid. And, you know, this person knows they need to apologize. But they're not doing it. They're not doing it. They're just waiting and watching. You know, shall I not? Okay. But they know they owe you an apology. And you're like just, you know, no one's talking about love out here. Both of y'all are just shut down. Three of Swords in reverse. Why is this their action? Why is the Three of Swords in reverse their action? Yeah, this person wants a reconciliation. They want to heal. This person wants to heal the connection. They want a reconciliation. They want to bring balance out here. Finally. This person wants peace and harmony for sure. They finally want what you want. Not in a way where they want commitment, but they definitely want peace and harmony. They want to reconcile. They want to, again, I'm repeating myself, but yeah, they want to heal the connection. All right. They want a resurrection or reconciliation. But yeah, they're giving it some time. All right. Slow and steady. That's how they want to go with it. They want to create a balance out here. If things were imbalanced earlier, they want to bring that balance in the connection. Ten of Pentacles in reverse. Why is this the action? Why is the Ten of Pentacles in reverse here? Yeah, see, you're not taking any action towards this person, okay? You're not taking any action towards this person out here, or you're just like very focused on yourself because this person isn't taking the lead out here, okay? But again, I think with the Ten of Swords in reverse here, I feel that you're trying to walk away from them. I said that before too, right? I think you're trying to move on from this person because the pain is too much. This person's coming in to heal the connection and you're just trying your best not to focus on this connection and just walk away. Your approach is very passive towards them. You're no longer being that badass, no longer being into that masculine energy where you get up and get things done. You're just, if it happens, happens. If it doesn't, that's fine. You're okay with it both ways. What's the moon in reverse? What's the moon in reverse? Wow, Three of Wands. I think this person out here, whatever happens, right? This person out here is, I think they're making a choice and they're going to come to you. They're making a choice and they're coming to you, okay? No matter what the obstacles, no matter what the deal is, right? This person is still choosing to come towards you, okay? This is a good, it's a good thing. The Three of Wands is a good thing. It's manifesting, right? So they are trying to work on themselves. So that they can come towards you. With the Eight of Pentacles out here. Moon in reverse here. I feel this is all kind of clarity that this person is getting slowly. They want a reconciliation. Whilst you are probably just no longer committed to this person or this situation out here. I think for right now, time being, you're just distancing yourself from them. Whilst they are taking their time to come towards you. But they definitely want a reconciliation. Okay. So that's what I have for you. Hope this reading resonates. And I'll see you next time. Bye-bye. Bye-bye.